Now, hair. Since I have nothing better to do with the rest of my day, I'm going to do my hair as well. But as you can see, it's like a darkish red auburn color, which I think works well with this. And it's tangled and horrible, so I'm going to show you the process of dealing with it. So the product that I'm going to be using in it right now, and then brushing it, it's something that my mother so kindly got for me. It's a split remedy, because my hair is incredibly long, as you can see, so it tends to get a lot of split ends. So I just put a pump or two, bring my hair over to one side. Yes, I'm wearing Cookie Monster pants. This is my Lazy Friday. Just rub it into the ends of your hair, because I also have bangs that I'm starting to grow out. I have to put it on those ends too. And do it to the other side. Alright, so now that it's all in there, I get to start the glorious process of brushing my hair. Long hair gets incredibly tangled incredibly fast. So that's one thing. Do I get through it pretty quickly? Since this is the Queen of Hearts, I'm going to part my hair down the middle to create a heart-shaped face. So now that I've got my hair parted, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create kind of bumps to go up like that. So you bring a section of your hair up and you tease it down so it's more easy to work with. And it creates volume. Look at that. Oh, volume. So as you can see, we have the beginning. I know it looks funny right now. We have the beginning of the heart shape. So just go up and over and up and over. Now excuse me while I get my hairpins. Now that I have my hairpins, this is going to look out a lot better. I'm going to be using bobby pins instead of regular U-pins. Because bobby pins work best when you're trying to mold your hair, and U-pins work best when you put it in a bun and you're using it to hold your bun in place or hold something into your hair. Alright, so now I'm going to start again on this heart shape. Alright, so now that we have that, you can push up your hair, grab a bobby pin, but first separate a section of hair from your temple, like that, okay? And then tuck it behind your ear, push it up, and place bobby pins to hold it there. See? Now that we you have the bumps in place. You can also use hairspray if you want. You have your two tendrils out. What I'm going to do, I'm going to brush both sides of these. You can tighten them, loosen them as you please. Alright, so now that you have your two ponytails in place. What I'm going to do is, this is called hemp organics, basically marijuana stuff. And it's a color hold, but it's a texturing glaze. I like to use it for curling my hair because it makes the curl stand out a lot more. So you just put a small amount in your hand. Woo! Rub it and work it through. What we're going to do is, this is my hot iron that's stuck under everything. As you can see, it has a spiral on it, which makes things a bit easier for me. And now I'm just going to plug it in. Because my hair is extremely hard to curl, I put it all the way up to 30. Which is probably bad, but oh well. In this stuff on this side, I know, I lied. I'm going to wash my hands real quick. Alright, now that my iron is ready to go, I want to make sure I get these out of the way. I know it looks silly now, but it's going to help you. Alright, so I'm just going to start with a small section. Even smaller, depending on how tight of ringlets you want. And actually go the extra mile and do really small. And you just hold it on for about 20-30 seconds. And then you have a nice little ringlet. Looking for my eyes are the windows to the soul. Looking to my eyes, eyes are you now. There is no surprise, eyes, because love is plain to see. Looking to my eyes, look into my eyes. Ponytails are all done. We're going to curl these tendrils, but you have to be very precise because you want it to curl outward that way. If you want, you can have it curling outward this way. Let's just see. Now you have curly tendrils on each side of your face. You can go over them if you want, or change how they look if you like. So now the hair is all done. What you can do, you can go back and do finer points, like turn this off first. Like for instance, I have my mascara, my eyelash curlers, my shiny glittery lip gloss out, and just in case you want to, reshape your eyebrows that you penciled in earlier. You can do that. Ooh. So I'm going to take this gloss. I'm going to put it on my brush and just pat it onto my lips. See? Now you have a shiny heart. I also have this, which is sparkling body gel, which you can pat on to your shoulders, your chest, right now. just to see if you can see it. I'm just rubbing it on. Oh no, no, you can't see it, but you can just rub it all over, put it on your neck, and this one's scented, so. And no, it's not because I like Twilight. It's because I like to motherfucking sparkle. Alright, so now we've got that on. Maybe you can see it now, but it's kind of shimmery. Oh well. So now, this is the final look. You're all done. You're all set to go partied up. Unless, of course, you want to put on mascara. This is waterproof. The only thing is you can't see it that well in the video. And the hair, and all the fine details. So, thank you very much for watching. Subscribe if you want to see more of this. I have a Twitter, which is @awkwardaddy. I have an Instagram, which is also @awkwardaddy. That's one word, spelt normal. I don't do weird spelling, but yeah. And let me know if you have any makeup requests or ideas for videos or things you'd like to see. Thanks so much.